Hello everyone and welcome in this video tutorial about Sonshot. In this video, we will see how to automatize your soundboard. So, in Sonshot, we have the concept of instructions. In the bottom left of the screen, we have the tab instruction. I can click on it. And currently, there is nothing because I have no instruction there. What I will do is simply, I will go in edit mode and I will drag and drop by clicking on the arrows on the instruction panel. And this add an instruction. You see here that there is the go button. I can press on it. And it plays the sound. Okay, now nothing too crazy. I will add another sound. Maybe for the intro of my show, I have this little jingle and then a rock music. I will go here and drag and drop this music. I will click the arrow to go back to the first instruction. I have the intro. I can click on go. And then you can see that it's already on Go Rock Music. I can click on it. And it plays the rock music. Currently, if I do it and I press Go right away, both are played at the same time. I may want the second sound to do a crossfade. I can go in the options of my instruction. And here I have some options. I can select as an action to make a crossfade. So now, if I play my instruction again, and if I click, it makes a crossfade. So far, so good. I will also rename the parent instruction, which is a group. I will call it my show intro. Yes, why not? Maybe I want my rock music to start automatically after my chord intro sound. So I clicked on the edit button and I will set it to auto start. We see that it's in auto start because we don't have a line here that indicates that I will need to trigger manually the instruction. I will press enter this time. And we will see that once the first jingle is over, the rock music will start. Okay, one last thing I can do, maybe I want the rock music to start while the first jingle is still running. To do that, I will go to the parent instruction. I will click here, and I will set it to simultaneous. It means that both sounds will not be played sequentially, but at the same time. Okay, so now if I launch it, they start at the same time, but since the second one is in crossfade, the first one disappears. But what I would like is maybe put a delay for the second one. I can do that. I go again in the options and I simply say delay before, maybe 4 seconds. Before trying it, I will just leave the edit mode here so that we can see the time. I will play go. You see the timer. So that's it for my show intro and playing sounds sequentially. What I can do if I'm satisfied with the result, I can save it, save instruction, and it will put it into a button. I will make a yellow button. And so I have here my show intro button. If I remove my instruction here, I can just play and press enter and it works. One example of things we can do with playing simultaneous sounds is, for example, a sad music. I will add some ambient sounds, maybe a rain. Okay. I will so put in simultaneous the group instruction. I will call it sad song with rain. I will put both sounds in auto start. I can try it. Okay, it works. It's not exactly what I want. The feeling is not that good. Maybe it would be better with fade in for to start the sound. I can already do that. Fade in on the music and fade in on the rain. Let's go again. It's better. I will make the rain start later. I will put a little delay, so maybe 2 seconds here. Sounds kind of good. And I can edit the sound in itself to make the rain not go too high. Okay, and I will try it again. Yeah, that's kind of what I want. So yeah, you can do things like that. Now we will see an other use case. We will see how to fire a random sound with only one button. The example I will use is with explosions. I may want to have one button that fire an explosion, but it will choose between different explosions. Let's do this. I simply drag and drop like for the other examples. And I will put all my sounds in auto start so that it doesn't require a trigger from the user. And now on the parent instruction, I will select random so that it picks randomly the next instruction to play. And I will say only play one instruction. And that's it. Now I can just do goal explosion. And it played randomly. Here it was the first one. I will play another one. It's again the first one. And it's the third one. No. So it's pretty good. I will rename this in random explosion. I will make it red. I will make it auto start. It will start. Okay. And I will save it on a button. I validate. Ah yes, it needs to use custom color. And now I can launch as many explosions as I want. And now we'll do a sound landscape with one background music and with random sounds that appears randomly. So to do that, we will do that in an horror setting. Let's go here. I will put this horror music as a background. So let's hear it. Yes, that's one. I will do inside this instruction, I will add another group instruction. And we will do something quite similar to what we have done with the explosions. So this group will be auto start. It will be random, only one instruction at a time. And we will add some instruction that we will put on it. What do I have as a monster? So if you link an item, it will be edited in the instruction. It will modify the item in your soundboard. Duplicate, it means that you can change the parameters in your instructions without affecting the existing item in your soundboard. Here I will just do link. Yes, validate. I will add another existing item. Monster. Link. Yes. And once again, I will add another monster. Monster snarl. Why not? Link. And I will validate. I will put them in auto start. It will be better for my use case. Okay. I will call this monster noises. I want this to loop. So I can set a lot of loops if I want, but I can also just put it to -1 so that it's infinity. It will not stop. I can also set a delay before, like I've done in the previous example. But what I will do here is put a delay before minimal. I will put it to 5 seconds and a delay before maximal, and I put it to 15 seconds so that it will play the sounds randomly between this duration. I will validate. Here is my landscape. I will call it horror landscape. I want my background music and my sounds to be executed at the same time, so I will put it simultaneously. And so I can make a try, I think. Let's go. So we see that here it's we have the delay that has been randomly picked. And then we have one randomly selected monster sound. Here we have again 12 seconds that has been selected. I hope we will have some slower delay. But so you can make something quite complex. Okay. So, okay, that was some example of how you can use the instruction systems. Here on top of the instruction, we can see that we have some buttons. We already saw that we can save in the button our instruction. Here there is a lock. The lock is useful to avoid the instruction to disappear once it is played. Typically, when we want to edit it, we want it to stay. When we want just to play it, we want it to disappear. Here we can delete the instruction, we can clear it, and there we can edit the instruction. When we are in edit mode, we have all the buttons. We have some button to move it, to reorder it. So that's it. That was a little overview of the instruction system. And thank you for watching, and see you soon for other videos about Sancho.